with me, it's in champagne, I like it for the excitement of where it starts to where it finishes, and helping it along and try not to take away from what it was originally. This is like cooking in a sense, where you take your raw ingredients and you add your spin on it without trying to detract from the product itself.
Bringing the people behind our food to life.
Sparkling wine is a process in which you take a base wine, which is your normal everyday sort of table wine, and you carbonize it in some manner or another. What makes a real good sparkling? It would definitely have to tell where it comes from, first and foremost. Just a sense of place, and then secondly, the varietal characteristic of it, that's coming through, either at Pinot Noir or Chardonnay. And thirdly, the stylistic, a creaminess, roundedness to it, which we can sometimes pull some of that from either barrel fermented on the primary or stainless steel fermented, where it'll be more vibrant and lively. Laurel Ridge has been around since the mid-80s. It was founded by Charles Corey. Charles Corey was one of the pioneers of the Oregon wine industry. There was a period of time where in 85, when Laurel Ridge was established, it started making sparkling shortly after that. 2006, I came in here, was a little hesitant on working with sparkling because I didn't have a whole lot of experience in it other than enjoying it. and basically just listened, learned from everybody around. I think that's the most important thing, is just listening to people and learning from them. And now we've been doing it for 3 years now, and it's been a lot of fun. I've seen it definitely grow tremendously since that time. I could see it easily growing twice that, three times that amount in within the next 2 or 3 years.
Cheers.
Hubris.
And it was good.
Oh, it was actually. Yeah, quite good.
Okay. Maybe we'll make another batch.
I think so. We could do that.